Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another differential equations problem today. This one is actually asking us to find the solutions of a differential equation problem. They ask us to find explicit solutions if possible, and if explicit solutions aren't possible, to find implicit solutions. So let's go ahead and dissect this problem. The differential equation that we're given is dy over dx equals negative 3y. And we're given an initial condition of y of 5 equal to 10. So whenever we're solving differential equations and we have an initial condition like this, the first thing that we're always going to want to do is separate the variables in the function. X is on one side and Y is on the other. We usually have Y's on the left and X is on the right. So we start by multiplying both sides by dx. And we get dy equals negative 3y dx. Then to continue separating variables, we divide both sides by y. In this case, I'm just going to go ahead and divide by negative 3y to separate the y's from the x's. So you can leave the negative 3 on either side. I'm going to move it to the left side. So you'll have dy over negative 3y equals dx. And it doesn't matter where that negative 3 goes, because all that matters is that you're pulling y's and x's apart, not where anything else in the equation is. So as long as we've got y's on the left and x's on the right. So let's go ahead now. The second step in any differential equation problem is to integrate both sides once we've separated those variables. So we've got them separated, and now we'll go ahead and integrate both sides like this. So integrating, we have here a coefficient. It's negative 1/3, right? Because we have this 3 on the bottom. We can pull that out in front of the integral. So we'll get negative 1/3 times the integral of dy over y equals the integral of dx. To make this a little bit simpler, we can pull the dy out of this fraction and just make this 1 over y. So I will change this to negative 1/3 times the integral of 1 over y dy equals the integral of x. So now that we have our variables separated, we have our integrals simplified, we go ahead and integrate. And integrating the left side will give us this negative 1/3 times the integral of 1 over a variable is natural log or ln of the absolute value of that variable, so ln of the absolute value of y, equals the integral, sorry, this is not x, this is dx. The integral of dx is x, I was probably thinking ahead there, and then of course we have to add c to the right side. We only add c to the right side, and we'll talk a little bit about c, but c is confusing because it's an aggregator of all of the constants in the problem, so we'll see it's gonna end up sucking some things together as we keep going with this problem. So anyway, more on that. After we've separated variables, integrated both sides, now what we need to do is go ahead and solve for y so that we can simplify all of this and then plug in our initial condition. So to solve for y, let's go ahead and multiply both sides by negative 3. That'll get rid of this coefficient here. So we'll be left with natural log of the absolute value of y equals negative 3x minus 3c. I just go ahead and distribute that. Then, to get rid of the natural log here, because remember we're trying to solve for y, we need to raise both sides of this equation to base e. In other words, the ln of y and the negative 3x minus 3c become the exponents here on these e's. So we raise both sides to base e because this e in natural log will then cancel out. So we'll be left with absolute value of y equals e to the negative 3x minus 3c. Let's go ahead now and simplify this exponent over here. What we need to do is use the formula that tells us that when we have a polynomial exponent on e, this e to the negative 3x minus 3c is the same thing as e to the negative 3x times e to the negative 3c. You can break apart the exponent like that as long as you remember to keep the negative signs. It's these two e's with their exponents multiplied together instead of everything in one exponent. So you break those apart, and then here's where we get to the part about c that's rather difficult. So we need to treat c as a constant. C is like a placeholder. It's not truly mathematical. It basically groups everything, all of the constants in the function together. So in other words, it's representing a constant. If you plug in a constant like the number 2 for c, you'll get e to the negative 6, and e to the negative 6 would just be some constant number. I could do the math here. It's 0.002478, etc. So this is a constant. So c, and it's not involved with the variable here, x. So this whole e to the negative 3c can be replaced by just c itself. So if we replace this with c, then c becomes a coefficient, and we have absolute value of y equals c e to the negative 3x. We can take the absolute value brackets off of y whenever we do that by adding positive or negative to the other side, y equals positive or negative c e to the negative 3x. But c, remember, is an aggregator of those constants, so it doesn't matter whether it's positive or negative because we're going to end up solving for c, so we can just drop this positive and negative here. So we've gone ahead and solved for y. This is our function. Now that we've done this, we can go ahead and plug in our initial condition, 5 for x and 10 for y. So we'll get 10 equals c e to the negative 3 times 5. The purpose of doing this is eventually to solve for c. So when we've done that, we get 10 equals c e to the negative 15. And to solve for c, let's go ahead and divide both sides by e to the negative 15 equals c. And because we have a negative sign on this exponent, we can make it positive by moving this whole e to the negative 15 to the numerator. That will cause the exponent to flip from a negative to a positive. So c is going to equal 10e to the negative 15. And now that we've solved for c, our last and final step is to go ahead and plug c, our answer for c, back into this function here, this equation that we found. So we have y equals, c is 10e to the 15, and then e to the negative 3x. So now that we have, now that we've plugged c back in, all we have to do is simplify, and we're done. So remember that rule before where we broke apart the two different terms that were in the exponent on the e and multiplied them together? Well, we can just reverse that, and we'll get y equals 10e, and then we can combine these exponents since these two e's are multiplied together, and we'll get 10e to the negative 3x plus 15. And that will actually be our final answer. And because we were able to solve for y and only have this y on the left side, this is an explicit solution as opposed to an implicit solution. So that's it. Hope that helped. I'll see you guys later. Bye.